So we're Christian Gwynn's parents. I'm Krista. This is Nevada, his dad. This is Nevada, the second one. And this is Victoria, his sister.
Can I get the spelling of your names, too?
Okay, so my name is KristaGwynn. This is NavadaGwynn. Same with this one. And VictoriaGwynn. Our son was 19. He was the last homicide, as y'all know, of 2019. In the neighborhood we live in now, we hear gunshots all the time, morning, noon, and night. So now this is my daughter who just turned 18, and she's ready to leave. She can't even walk to the store because she's scared of a stray bullet. I take her to the store. I take her to work. I take her to the bus. My daughter should not be 18 and scared to walk the street. When I was 18, when my husband was 18, we walked from neighborhood to neighborhood. My daughter won't leave the house because every time we move, we hear gun violence. So now we're up, we're ready to move. We feel the neighborhood we live in is unsafe, and I shouldn't feel like that. I shouldn't be scared that my child is gonna go outside and not come back, or my husband be so worried when I go to the store. Are you okay? Where you at? Did you hear that? What neighborhood you in? We shouldn't be afraid. I'm too old to be afraid, but we are. My daughter is too young to not want to live her life, but she's petrified. My 12-year-old, her friend spends the night at my house because they don't want to go outside and play. She's 12. Why is she not in the front yard playing, riding a bike up and down the street? Because she's scared that when the car ride down with tinted windows, is that going to be a gun violence going to happen? Is that going to be a drive-by? My son was killed by a drive-by. And now every car with tinted windows, we think twice. We shouldn't be scared. My son shouldn't be dead. But now this is how we live it, and it's sad. It's sad that my 12, my 13-year-old, my husband's petrified for our family. I have an autistic son who don't leave the house. Now he really won't leave. He's 23.
And what part of town are you guys? Chickasaw, Russell, where are you guys located?
Near the Shawnee golf course.
Okay, so you guys in the Shawnee neighborhood?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
That's all we have, son.
And Chris, if you could, Chris, would you mind sending us a picture of their son later on?
Yeah, I'll send it to you.
Great.
When did you guys decide, basically, that enough was enough, that you're gonna make a move?
Well, when every time I pull up in my driveway, no less than 8:30, 9 o'clock, just hear rapid fire. It's like every night, and I don't know. It's like now I'm sleeping in my house with my beds behind walls because I don't know if anything's going to fly through my window. Like I said, I sympathize with the Quan House family. Yes. And I understand. And that was a moment in my life when that happened with him. I prayed that it didn't ever happen to my son. And here I am a few years later with my son, I'm sure. And it hurts. Been in this city for 30 years. I've lived in Louisville for a while. I've had a lot of fun times here in the city. But not here 30 years now, down the line, I feel like my heart has just been broken. Just been broken. So it's just time for me to get my family away from here.
When we eating breakfast one morning and my 18-year-old come in and say, Mom, I think I'm ready to leave the neighborhood. I no longer feel safe. I'm a mother. I'm gonna protect mine. So it's time to go.
When you see this, does it make you think that it's not getting better or that it is getting better?
We feel like arresting them is getting better. And I see this, and I'm hoping when they test these guns, maybe one of these guns is the one that killed my son. Maybe they can put the fingerprint on one of these guns that took my son's life. So when I see that, I'm looking at, it's one of those that took my baby. And if it is, I hope they got him. So we can get peace. Every time they lock somebody up with a gun, I'm hoping that they test it. Did they take my son's life? I hope it is the gun that took my son's life. That way we can get closure. We don't have no closure.
When I see the faces that you guys have arrested on this board here, I just hope that someday I can see the face of the guys that took my My son was a good kid.
He was 19.
He had just came home from Job Corps. He graduated in 6 months and 2 years ahead of his ninth grade class. He was a great kid. He came out $30 an hour in brick masonry. He was just becoming a young man, starting his own career. He had just turned 19 on his birthday. Christian was given to me November 28th on Thanksgiving Day. My son was taken 2 weeks after Thanksgiving Day, after his birthday of 2019.
It was her big brother, and on her shirt, they 2 years apart. She called him her baby brother because that's the way they play. My son wasn't no criminal. He wasn't no gangbanger. He wasn't no drug dealer. All he wanted to do was to make us smile and have a good time. She called him her baby brother, even though he 2 years older than her, and he found it hilarious. And somebody took my boy away for no reason because he was coming home 30 minutes before his curfew. He was 19. He had a curfew, and he respected it. And he was on his way home, and you took my son away from me at 9:30. How crushing is that? 30 minutes, three blocks away. My son was three blocks away from his house, and you gunned my boy down. That's horrifying. And we'll never get that back, and we'll never be able to sleep soundly again because my son is gone, and my daughter's petrified, and my 12-year-old feel like she stopped growing because she can't enjoy life, and we sure enough can't enjoy the neighborhood. And we live next to a park. How ironic is that? I can walk out my door and walk to the park and watch my kids play. They don't want nothing to do with it. We want an answer, and we want closure.
Thanks a lot, y'all.
Thank you.
Thank you all.
Thank you, Daddy.
Thank you.